purpose of the litigation is to protect the water resources out this Oklahoma, to preserve it for many generations, you know, to come. And we'll make sure y'all understand the lawsuit is not about money. It's not about solid water. The case is still in court order mediation process. Judge West's mediation order restricts the parties and us from discussing the details of what's going on in the case. However, all parties seem to be negotiating in good faith. I think we've said that since the beginning. I think the biggest portion has been education. I know Ty and Brian and them can tell you that, as you all know, I think in the beginning they just thought, oh, there's all that water in Southeastern Oklahoma, so let's just get it and let's try to use it. I think they're finding out what's important is good lake level management plan, you know, protection of our wildlife, protection of our life as we know it. So it's that is still in going on. The legal and factual issues are complex, but the legal issues in play go back to treaties the nations entered into in with the federal government early 1800s. I think most of you all knew that. I don't know if you're aware now, the Department of Justice and the Department of Interior are now involved in the mediation process. I don't know if you all are aware that they are our trustee. You know, meaning we signed the contract, treaty, dance, and rep, quick. I see a judge nodding his head. And so because of that, they are also supposed to help us protect our resources. So it's nice to have the federal government being involved and truly helping back us in what we're doing. And it also gives a little bit of power in regards to money and all those things that's bigger than the state of Oklahoma. So that helps a lot as well. There is a mediation session scheduled in Washington, D.C. in December with them involved. Even though we say Sardis Lake initiated the lawsuit, I think all of y'all know that we want to make sure that we protect all resources of water in Southeastern Oklahoma and the Chickasaw Nation area as well. We hope that the mediation will be concluded by early next year. You know, however, we want to make sure that we get it right. You know, I don't care if it takes 10 years, 15 years. We want to make sure we get it done right. So I don't want a timeline to be pushing us as opposed to getting it right, proper lake level management plans, and making sure we protect our area. You know, and I know the issue of selling water always comes up. Again, this is not about selling water. It's not about money. It's all about preserving our water resources for many generations to come. The law does prohibit out-of-state water sales. We have no interest in selling water to anyone. I think y'all know that. We want to protect it and use it for us as we plan for the future. You know, we have been blessed with precious water resources. You know, even though it's been dry, it is, thank goodness you can hear it coming down right now. We'll continue to get some more. All parties to the lawsuit have seen the determination of the nations, us and the Chickasaws. And the resource they're willing to dedicate to the preservation of our water. I don't know if y'all realize, but we have spent a lot of money. I mean, and I hope that you and our tribal members see that it's been a good use of our money. This is going to be our most precious, we all understand that that's going to be our most precious commodity for the future, for the growth of Oklahoma, for the way of life. I mean, you can read articles after articles that water is the number one issue across the whole world, not just here in the state of Oklahoma. So I just want to make sure that y'all understand that we are going to remain and committed to this cause, no matter what the cost is, because I know it's kind of like, I always say this water situation is kind of like my grandson. There's no price on my son that you can put a price on them for anything. So does anybody have any questions? Over. Yes, sir.
I got in at 11, sorry about that. About 4 or 5 years ago, y'all was looking to get a water quality study going. I wonder how
that was. Tom, you
mind? Yeah, we've got a plan in place. We're going to start attacking some impaired streams. There's a thing called the 303D list. And whatever the impairments are on those, find out the best way to tackle those. Maybe a watershed based plan. See if there's a point source of pollution There's typically these on-point sources coming in throughout the month. So we do have a water quality program planning in place. So Mark, if that was a goal.
Can you speak up? I know I can't hear that.
The Mark, if that was from Coldwax.
Did y'all hear that? Mercury level from the coal plants, is that what you said?
That's correct.
Yeah, fair. That's something that, you know, we're keeping up, we're kind of keeping up with DEQ on, and they've got a little more expertise than I on that, so kind of referring to them. I don't have an answer for you on that, but if you give me your information, I'll let you know what you can do. If you have a place, if you have a particular place in mind, I'd like to.
And just to let you, I think everybody here knows that Brian and Ty have been involved in this from, I guess, day one. I mean, I know Brian was, Ty came on. Of course, later Ty is basically is involved very much in the environment and knowing all the quality studies that needs to be done and all that. And I mean, I guess you've been in every meeting. So if you have any technical questions from the environment, you know, I would say that Ty's the person to ask that question, and Brian, if there's any legal or legislative or policy issues, if there's anything in regards to that. But is there any other questions? I guess I keep saying for me is it's great that this has started. I think about this started in Little Ampers, Oklahoma. I mean, y'all started the water fight long, many years ago. But then it's so great to see us become unified back in Atmers and us continue to be together and to start seeing legislators show up to these types of meetings and to have people that's wanting to show up and be involved and understand the importance. I don't know that 10 years ago that everybody really understood the importance of water and how critical it's going to be for us. But anyway, thank you for allowing me to speak, and God bless. Thank you very much.